Our body's immunity is its capability to resist harmful external microbes such as bacteria, viruses, parasites, and fungi. Hi, my name is Madhur Kothare, and I'm going to walk you through the functioning of a part of our immune system, which is our skin. Our immune system has many components, each designed for a specific purpose. I have broken them down into four parts, as you can see. These parts belong to two types of immunities we have, innate and acquired. I tried to look up for a diagram on internet that will make the explanation of the immune system simple. But everything I found was complicated because the immune system itself is so complex. So I decided to create my own version. But this is the simplest I could make it. The first layer of defense our body has is its various protective barriers. The first and the most visible barrier is our skin. It repels attacks by pathogens all the time. Besides that, it performs many other immune tasks. We'll look at them one by one. The first immune function of our skin is providing a physical barrier. The skin prevents entry and penetration of harmful pathogens into it. Pathogens are bacteria, viruses, parasites, or fungi that are harmful to our body. Not all microbes are pathogens. Patho means relating to disease. Pathogens are those microbes that generate disease in a way. Some bugs perform tasks that are helpful to our body and so are called good microbes. A strong and firm skin without cuts and breaks resists the repeated attacks of pathogens much better. There are fatty compounds called ceramides and a protein material called collagen that help the skin in that process. It is a good idea to try and maintain a healthy, firm skin with proper nutrition and care. The second immune function of the skin is secreting antimicrobial chemicals. The skin maintains a pH of less than 5.5. This acidic pH suppresses the growth of various harmful bacteria, viruses, parasites, and fungi on the skin. The skin produces and secretes various oil-based antimicrobial compounds that kill invading pathogens. Avoid using skin cleansers containing harsh chemicals or preservatives. They will remove the antimicrobial coatings secreted by the body, making it vulnerable to pathogens. Always look for pH-balanced cleansers. The third immune function of your skin is classical and indirect. In the presence of sunlight, your skin helps produce vitamin D, which has many positive roles in our immunity. So it is a healthy habit to expose our skin routinely to sunlight for at least a short period of time on a daily basis. The time frame of exposure will depend on the location and the time of the year and whether the skin color is white, brown, or dark. If you live in higher latitudes that are nearer to the polar region than the equator, you will need more sun exposure. You will need a longer sun exposure in winters than in summers. If you have brown or dark skin, you will need a longer time in the sun because your skin has more melanin, which absorbs ultraviolet rays that are needed for the production of vitamin D. Now don't forget that when the weather is cold, we wear more layers of clothes. That decreases the skin area on which sun rays fall, making it harder to produce vitamin D in colder weather. I'll cover this in more detail in another video. The fourth immune function performed by skin is nourishing good microbes on it. They are called normal skin flora. There are millions of microbes on our skin that are actually good for the body. They reduce the area available for the bad microbes to attach to our bodies. They also make the pathogens compete for the same nutrients. These good microbes balance our skin's pH and even protect against skin cancer. Using antibacterial soaps, applying creams with a lot of preservatives or harsh chemicals to our skins, and even consuming antibiotics damage this good skin bacterial flora. Our quest for super hygiene is actually bad for our normal hygiene. If you found this information useful, click on the like button below. In the videos that follow, we'll look at various micronutrients and macronutrients that help our skin perform these immune functions better. Click in the box in the middle to see more videos on this topic. Click in the circle on the right to subscribe to this channel. And never forget, ignorance is a very bad strategy when it comes to protecting yourself from infections.